This contest is an inter-promotional six-man tag team match and is set for one fall. Introducing team number one, representing UCWL, first from the Himalayan mountains, J-Cole.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this interpromotional six-man tag match here at CAW All Stars 10. I am the voice of Universal Championship Wrestling League, V-Pac, here, and I'm being joined by the voice of UWL, Jason Brown.
Thank you for having me, V-Pac. It is quite an honor to be here. And just listen to this jam-packed arena. All these screaming fans and everything. Just to see what CAW is all about here tonight at the CAW All Stars. Once again, thank you for allowing me to be a part of this commentary team.
You're welcome, man. Well, as the case, yeah. It's going to be three members of UCWL's Cruiser X Division taking on three superstars from UWL. And as Jago is on, is coming into the ring. And wait, hold on a second. He's coming out next. Oh, boy. Jason, you're going to need this umbrella. Everybody get under the umbrellas now.
What? The weather's fine. What in the world are you talking about? The weather's fine. It's sunny.
I'm telling you, Jason, you're gonna need the umbrella. Like everything will make sense in a few seconds.
You're confusing me, man. You're scaring me. Confused right now. How this happened?
I don't know how he does this.
Give me that damn umbrella.
You should see it when he makes it rain indoors.
What?
Yeah, he makes it rain indoors.
How is that possible?
I don't know how he does it.
This suit was new. This was brand new. And now it's all wet.
Well, you could send Rain the cleaning bill.
Jesus. Oh, that's one way to make an entrance. Change the damn weather.
I'm sorry about that, Jason. Can we get a towel for him, please?
And now it's sunny again. What the hell?
And their tag team partner, from Hampstead, New York, Return Rider, Nova!
As we get a towel for Jason here, here comes the third and final member of Team UCWL, the human rocket known as Nova.
Now, apart from nearly getting a code here now, I have to say, your team is looking pretty good right now. Pretty damn good. I mean, you got a man that can change the damn weather. And now... Was not expecting this.
Sorry about that.
You should have warned me beforehand, man. Come on.
Okay. Well, in any case, here comes the UWL team.
All right, this is my team. Now here comes probably one of the best high flyers in UWL.
Representing UWL. First, he is the leader of the Cooper Gang, Sly Cooper.
Like I said, this is one of the best high flyers in UWL, Sly Cooper. Blink and you'll miss it. This man is so damn quick, and he's able to pull things just out of nowhere. I mean, you're in for one hell of a treat right now, I'll tell you that.
Alright, I'll take your word for it, but yeah, he's gonna... I'm actually looking forward to seeing what he can do against Nova.
That is an interesting matchup right there. You know, many people call Sly the ace of the junior heavyweights in UWL. And he's going to show you why here tonight.
His tag team partner, originally from Zaifungu Pro Wrestling, Tiger the Dog.
Now here comes a man who's definitely a huge up-and-comer in CAW, Tiger the Dark. Current UWL Intercontinental Champion, longest reigning champion currently in UWL. He's still so young, yet he has the skills of a veteran.
Oh, that's gonna... Well, I guess that should come in handy for him.
I know. He's only been in this for 2 years. Only in this for 2 years.
2 years and he's already the Intercontinental Champion over in UWL.
Yep, and he's the inaugural UWL Intercontinental Champion, by the way.
Oh, wow.
Now here he comes. The Ace!
Entering in style.
That's how our champion does it.
He is the ace of UWL, Jotaro Kujo.
Like I said, this man right here, he is the ace. He is the global champion, Jotaro Kujo. Jotaro, he has a combination of both speed and power.
I've actually seen a few of his matches over in UWL, so I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yes, there's a reason why he's the ace of our league. And he's coming out here to lead his group here tonight.
Well, we're gonna see just how well the UWL stars can match up with the UCWL Cruiser X division.
Yeah. just feel the intensity of this crowd right now. This is going to be one hell of a match.
And I can already tell it will be.
It's sending goosebumps up. Not me.
And here we go, bells rung. It's going to be Sly Cooper starting off with Jago.
As Jago has Sly down. Sly just reversed it. I told you. Blinking, you miss it. Now Sly has him up against the ropes there on the UWO side.
Yeah, that referee had to get in between both of them. Up.
Headlock there by Sly. Sweeps the legs.
Ooh, that forearm.
Oh, look at that. Jago, jawbreaker, and out. Oh, look at what is this?
Oh, detonation kick.
And right to the side of Sly Cooper's head.
And now working the leg there. Now that's pretty smart. Sly, he's a high flyer, so one thing you gotta do is keep him grounded.
Well, Jago's known to take to the air as well. Oh, that's now.
Oh!
Backdrop suplex. Sly's going to the top rope here.
Uh-oh.
Ah! Imploding 450 there by Sly.
So far, very impressive by Sly Cooper. Northern Lights does not hold the bridge, though.
Looks like he knows that going for the pin right now would be kind of pointless, as both men are still getting their legs in.
Ah, oh, brain buster there by Sly.
Oh, that's the Jago, though, back to his feet. He's got...
Uh-oh.
And a stun gun.
Oh!
Across the top rope there by Jago.
Nicely done there.
And now here's the tag. Here comes Nova.
Uh-oh, this is the one I wanted to see.
Nova's known as the Human Rocket.
Oh!
The suplex slide there. See how they have Sly right there in their corner.
Oh, look at that. Dropkick there by Sly Cooper.
Alright, Squips. Nova into the UWO corner. And now tags in Tiger the Dark.
And a big boot.
Yeah, nice double teamwork by the UWL team.
Tiger the Dark. He's just stalking Nova. And that's one thing you also see. Tiger the Dark has a mean streak.
Oh, wait. Look at that, though. Nice counter there.
Taking it to the youngster.
Yeah, look at Nova tagging Jago back in.
Is he going for some kind of submission hold here? Wait, no!
Oh, smashes both knees.
Jago driving the knees of Tiger the Dark down, but look at this, Tiger fighting back now. Wait, what is this? Cradle fisherman suplex there. And now.
Oh, jumping elbow. Nicely done there by Tiger the Dark. Now, one thing I will have to say, if Tiger is able to hit the darkness driver, one move... Oh! Like I said, the darkness driver, one move that has not been kicked out of.
Yeah, I've heard of this move. I believe it's a tombstone, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep, it is a tombstone pile driver.
What kind of submission hole is this?
That is a figure four sharpshooter.
Well,
as you can see, he locks the legs in like a figure four, but then just turns it around into a to a sharpshooter. But well, now...
Yeah, Jago was able to escape out of it.
Like I said, he's still young, so he's... So he's still trying, you know...
And up, Jago makes the tag. Here comes rain.
Uh-oh, please don't make it rain again.
Yeah, we don't want Jason to get even more damp than he is now.
You think that would be part of his offense, though? You know, make it rain so your opponent would slip.
Well,
here comes the ace!
Oh, boy. Jotaro's in. Backdrop suplex there. And tags in Sly Cooper.
Well, I guess Jotaro just got his shit in and got out. Smashing the arm there by Sly. Now Sly going out on the apron. And a... 450 splash! Springboard!
Yeah, very impressive there by Sly Cooper.
Takes him down with that suplex. Rain trying to crawl over this corner, but Sly keeping him away, keeping him in the, to the UWL corner. Uh-oh.
Oh, Rain now. No.
Oh!
And now Sly sending Rain into the corner. Rain! That's one way to take down a high flyer like Sly Cooper. Focus on the legs.
Like I said, that's how you keep them grounded. That's how you keep a high flyer grounded. Without their legs, they're pretty much, you know, pretty much 90% of their offense is handicapped. And now, jawbreaker there by Sly. Forearm shot. And a Michinoku driver!
Yeah, nicely executed there by Sly. Sends Rain in the corner again. Oh, that's the Rain fighting out of the corner now, but...
Sly gets out of the way there. Cut the leg.
Yeah, blocking the kick and backdrop suplex. Sly's going to the top here.
He went for the spiral landing, but Rain moved out of the way. Uh-oh. Picked him right back up. Oh!
Oh, that was impressive. Just getting right out of the... What did you call that? The spiral landing?
Yep, the spiral landing.
Oh, Jotaro's in.
The ace. Big boot.
Yeah. Unless Rain makes the tag. Nova's in.
I don't know where Jotaro's going. Now he's meeting Nova's foot. Now he meets his forearm.
Nice takeover there by Jotaro.
He has Nova against the rope. Oh, trying to dump the ace out of the ring, but Jotaro's still hanging on. And gets clocked right in the face.
Well, that's one way to take the guy out of the ring.
And the referee begins to count. Pretty brave there, Nova. Over there in the UWO side.
Backdrop suplex again there by Nova on the outside.
Sly just glaring at Nova there.
Crucifix driver on the outside.
Oh!
Referee's up to four.
Jotaro bouncing Nova's head up against the apron and then drop kicking him in the back of the head. Uh-oh. Like I said, look at the power of Jotaro Kujo!
Yeah, very impressive. Deadlift gut wrench there on the Nova.
He just runs him right in the... He's just running him into Tiger the Dark's boot.
Oh, yeah, that was a good thing Nova got back in. I think the ref was up to nine. What is this?
Argentine backbreaker into...
Oh, neckbreaker!
Jitaro's got something planned here.
Could it be going up for the JoJo's adjustment?
Nails it!
The cover! One!
Two! Ah, kick out there by Nova! Kicking out the Aces finisher there.
And now, yeah, Jotaro sending Nova into the UWL corner.
Nova escaping whatever Jotaro was going up there for. Now stomping on the Ace.
And a snap suplex.
Nicely done there. And now... Oh! Working on the neck there.
Oh, Nova could be... I think he's thinking gravimetric blaster.
Oh!
And I think Tiger the Dark realized the same thing.
As he just tosses Nova off. Nova kind of landed on Jotaro there a little.
Jotaro now sending Nova back into the UWL quarter. Here's a tag.
Here comes Sly.
Oh!
Vertical suplex with a cross-body combo there.
And now Sly. Middle rope.
Oh! Chug off for a middle rope Phoenix splash, but Nova gets out of the way. That's the thing with high flying, high risk. Sometimes it isn't always the best.
Oh, look at this though, Sly fighting out of the powerbomb.
And
he's going one for his own.
Set up powerbomb there by Sly, and now Rain is now in the ring.
Jeremy with the bridge.
One,
two, no.
Oh.
Rain now. Oh!
I don't know what
Rain was thinking, but he just got hit with a big knee by Sly Cooper.
Rain trying to fly himself, but he got clocked there. Uh-oh, what?
What's Sly doing? Oh.
Dead left German!
Oh, that was impressive. Now sending Rain into the corner.
And now Rain's up on the top. He has Rain up on the top now.
Rain counters.
Flying crossbody.
Yeah, and now
I don't think Rain saw that. Oh! Taking out two men at once.
Yeah, Ray, too busy talking to the crowd, got clobbered by Jotaro.
Right in the back of his ass.
And, what a move that was.
It was like a fall away slam into a Samoan drop.
Oh, now Jotaro's got Rain.
Up in that torture rack position. And takes him down with the neck breaker. Jotaro feeling the effects of this match already.
Yeah, I think he's trying to stalk Rain.
Trying to get into his head. JoJo's adjustment!
One, two, and Nova trying to come in and... Well, I'll be damned!
What a match there! And it ends with the Ace hitting his signature move.
Yeah, I guess congratulations to you guys!
Thank you very much! We came to win, and that's what we did. But you know what? Hard fought effort on your side. Give it up for everyone in this match.
Yep. Well, don't go anywhere. There's more action to come here at CAW All Stars 10. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to one of the first festivities of CAW All Stars 10, our pre-show event, and the Crazy Stuff Division is back. I'm Sean Walsh. I'm being joined here on commentary with Jared Extreme and multi-time world champion Mason Chronic.
But I feel very intimidated right now.
Yeah, shut the fuck up.
But before we get to that, we're going to send it backstage in the studio to our correspondent for this match, Mr. Adam Jackpot.
Thank you, Sean. Of course, the Crazy Stuff of People's Division is back, and we've had a little bit of an issue as of late. Of course, our current champion, Alex Jones, no longer champion after our president, Donald Trump, stripped him of the belt because he was called the lizard person. And tonight, we're going to see the belt not only crowned for a third champion, but it will also be defended in the second half of our 60-man, 59-man rumble. And we'll take it back to you, Sean.
Thank you. So you heard it right there. We're going to crown a new champion here for the first part of this match, and then we're going to have that whoever that champion is, they'll be forced to defend it right away. You guys ready? We got Kanye West out here.
All of a sudden, I feel like slavery was just a choice.
Oh, man, be careful about that. You'll get called a racist in the comment section.
Oh, no. But I've said it more than I'm accuracy.
See, I don't know about you, but I would much rather be at the Crunchyroll press conference than be here.
That's because you get paid for that.
Yeah, you're welcome for that, by the way.
Hold on.
You're welcome.
You had nothing to do with it.
If anything, you guys should be thanking Chronic.
Exactly.
Kanye West wrestling in one of his $100 plain white shirts, and oh my god.
Oh man, it's one of the best women's wrestlers in the world, James Ellsworth.
I like his shirt.
I like his chin.
What chin?
Oh.
Look at it. It's right there below the waist.
Oh. I don't think that's his chin.
What do you call it?
I don't know what it's called, but Carmella hasn't seen it.
Exactly.
I don't think Carmella wants to see it.
Well, I mean, guys, what do you think of the odds here for these two competitors? I mean, James Ellsworth has got to have the advantage, don't you think?
I mean, you'd think so, but I mean, James Ellsworth, I mean, he's looking for a job. He just recently got laid off, and he could very well become the first ever. Well, new Crazy Stuff People's Division champion.
Alex Jones,
we're going to pretend that didn't exist, right? What the hell is that?
We got our sponsors.
That is a work of art. That is beautiful.
I'm quite a fan of those side plates, if I must say so.
That is beautiful. Well.
Please don't tell me this obnoxious music. Okay, thank God.
James Ellsworth is going to have to look out for the poop-diddy-scoop slam.
Oh, oh man. Yeah. If he hits that, this one might be over. And I know only one entrant has come out here, but then no one else will come out here because they will all leave the build.
I'm just glad that that stupid music stopped playing. It was really annoying.
Fun fact, James Ellsworth, second time appearance.
Ah. Uh-oh. And out comes...
Rommable.
Rommable?
He's gonna...
Oh my god. It's actually a Bravo Ball.
Does anyone else smell bad?
We cloned the rock. We found a piece of his eyelash. Good. We combined it with a bowl.
Interesting. You know, you can never say that we run out of ideas here in the Crazy Stuff Division.
Who can thank President Donald Trump, who will be in this match as...
Ooh, it is the Black Panther.
Wakanda forever.
He's representing FCWL.
Yes.
Ah.
Black Panther beating up the dumb motherfucker.
Now, Chronic, you were making mention of a smell.
It smells like Dwayne Johnson's Rotten Tomato reviews.
Oh. Ooh. Jumanji got good reviews, but... Captain,
But Rampage and Skyscraper, neither of them are good.
Nope. But here comes my personal hero, Captain Planet.
And this motherfucker will turn you into a tree.
I'm gonna turn you into a tree? Well, I mean, Mason Chronic sounded a bit like a robot at the moment.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Jared Extreme sounded a bit like
That sounded a little racist.
Jared, if I'm not mistaken, this is your return to commentary.
It is, yes. And oh my god, we're being blessed with the Lord and Savior himself.
Here comes Jesus.
And, ooh.
Dressed for the occasion.
He's got a nice little, halo on. Looks as though we've lost contact with Mason Chronic. His headset has left the arena, and now it looks like he's joined us again.
I had to go get a Hot Pocket. I do apologize. It is a pizza Hot Pocket given to us by this crazy stuff, whatever the fuck it is.
Oh, and Black Panther with a big stomp, and looks like
man,
a longtime fan favorite has returned.
Guys, cancer's back.
Oh my god.
That is, if I think of the human embodiment of cancer, that is what I think it would look like.
There goes Ellsworth.
I do think I did beat up his tag partner before.
Oh yeah, yeah. I mean he is part of a famous tag team.
Now cancer, this is his second appearance in this baby.
This is
Kanye West is he's beating this. Cancer.
Hey.
Oh yeah, here we go.
From CAW All Stars, what was that Dunox thing?
Seven.
Jack the Jobber.
Is that seven?
Oh, that's beautiful.
Maybe eight.
Well, he's back.
Yeah,
he's
Jack's
back. Now
representing
Cultaholic.
What culture was banned from showing up, but Jack now with Cultaholic.
You guys
Jack
think,
almost wait, getting eliminated by the Brahma Bowl.
Do you guys think we may be looking at one of the top 10 wrestlers of the week in this match?
Very well could, but I mean the question is: are Will Ospreay and or Zack Sabre Jr. going to be in this match?
Nah.
Okay. What about the number one wrestler every day? He's right there, being beaten down by the Brahma Bull.
Jesus.
Yes, he's always in our hearts. He's my number one wrestler.
Guys, I'm confused. Is that Jesus or is that Seth Rollins? I always have trouble differentiating.
No, Seth Rollins is too busy like having an affair or something.
Jesus and CrossFit Jesus.
And Kanye's been eliminated.
And there goes Yeezy.
By ironically, an African.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, I mean, he says slavery was a choice. Black Panther proving that bitch no one wasn't.
Uh-huh.
I don't want to work with this man.
Jack attacking Black Panther saying he's Spider-Man guy.
I have big news because tonight is a somber note, but it's also a happy note. The last remaining Klansman of the Kane family are going to be competing here tonight, and this is one of them. It's Here Comes the Kane.
That's,
And there goes Jesus.
Wow.
Jesus, eliminated by Hell's favorite demon. That's very
ironic,
symbolic.
Isn't it?
Very symbolic.
Ladies. Well, Jared, you are a lady.
Who are you calling a lady, bitch?
Jared's a lady. Tonight, guys, we've been hearing about it since the Canes started, but somewhere tonight, the Kane of Kane, Glenn Jacobs himself, will be here.
Oh. Libertarian Kane?
No.
Jacob Goodnight from the Cena Evil movies?
The next
guys, I wonder
there,
if Brock Lesnar's teeth are going to be an entrance in this match.
Huh?
Well, speaking of entrance, you know... Oh?
Uh-oh. Here's something that's just not possible unless you're watching the Bumblebee movie.
Exactly.
Heel Cena. Which
John
looks
Cena
like it's just John Cena.
Bumblebee.
Because it is John Cena. And there goes Jack!
Oh, no. Oh, poor Jack.
We were speaking about entrance in this.
See, I was just
there
hoping
was a man,
this would be John Cena in heels, but it's just
there was a man
it's
I,
just John
I,
Cena.
I endorsed a man to get in this rumble named El Cronico. Where is he? He was denied entrance.
What a bitch.
Well,
exactly, what a bitch.
Chronic Trump. Trump's the president, so.
The Brahma Bull laying the smack down on whatever that is.
Here comes the Kane.
Here comes the Kane.
Cancer's still in here. Cancer, really strong.
I guess you could say
is
that.
This,
yeah.
If, would you say this is stage 4?
It doesn't seem to be receding anytime soon. Oh!
Oh, no.
And, oh.
Yes!
And everyone's about to get raped?
I love this man.
Here comes Harvey.
I admire this man.
He was let out of jail for the night only.
And
cancer.
He looks like
look
his face
cancer.
Is made out of Play-Doh.
You know, Jared, I have to ask. You know, Cancer's out here with his dominant performance. How do you stop Cancer?
Which family member has it this week?
No, the answer is you don't.
Now, Walsh.
Yes.
Question.
Answer.
You've been a part of All Stars 10 years.
I have, yes.
Why does Cancer have a never give up?
You
howl.
Never give up Cancer. Did you ever think you'd see Harvey Weinstein here? And God.
I did think I would see God.
By the way, his son was here earlier. Daddy's in the house now.
Making his first match appearance since Backlash 2006.
God is also a former ROH competitor. God, he has made ROH appearances.
His holiness is just lighting up this arena with his fury.
Will God avenge his son by attacking Here Comes the Kane?
Hold on, Jesus was already in this matchup. How is he coming back in already?
Don't tell me it's the W. It's George W. Bush.
It's the F legend.
It is.
And he might be, he's already eliminated. No, he's not. Never mind.
Oh, and the Brahma Bull God.
It was almost as disappointing as his presidency.
Well, I have to say,
the Brahma Bull.
Crazy Stuff Division now exists. Donald Trump owns half of this company with you. Did you ever think 10 years this is what happened?
No. I definitely did not think that was even remotely a possibility. I should have thought that.
It's TCF Legend!
That's right. Default making his way out here. Well accomplished, Star.
I must say, it is Call Stars 10, and the names are coming out tonight. Jesus, God, Harvey Weinstein, Bush,
Cancer,
Default, Captain Planet's still in here.
Captain Planet, the Iron Man of this matchup so far, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeezy was here, and Kanye West, and there goes Bush!
I gotta tell you, these Hot Pockets given to us by the whatever the fuck this is, delicious. Delicious.
You can thank Trump for that. That's right from Trump Towers. Best Bowls in the world.
I am so glad I voted for that man.
Oh, what the hell?
Wait a minute. Oh, see, you can't beat it. Odds. You can't beat it.
You see, look, Captain Planet would be the man that can beat cancer. He wants to protect the environment.
I think he's about to do it. Oh, no. Never mind.
See, every time you think you beat cancer, it just comes back.
Cancer, the beast.
You know,
God gonna eliminate people?
By the way, I'm super high. Where are we?
Oh, wow.
We are in Insert City. Here.
Like I said, I would much rather be at the country with us.
We're Los Angeles. China.
Suddenly my dick feels smaller.
Here comes China. She's back.
Jared, now I gotta warn you. Don't treat her like a woman. Don't treat her like a man.
Just treat her like a person.
We can't have her in here because remember, if you look up her name, you'll find porn.
Well, remember, Donald Trump has a lot of issues with China.
Well, Jared...
Yeah,
he certainly does.
Jared, you understand that same sentiment also goes for Harvey Weinstein.
Very true. But, I mean, it's more or less rape, not porn. And here comes
Christopher Lopinski!
Making his return from last year!
New legacy legend himself.
There are many wrestling hero slams going on in this ring right now.
Well, boys, if I'm not mistaken, we are at full capacity at the moment. God, Cancer, Christopher Notwinski, Default, Harvey Weinstein. Here comes Kane! And, Captain Planet is still strong.
Love me a Captain Planet.
Just understand, guys, if I'm not mistaken, our next entry, I think, will be 17. That's barely scratching the surface of this 60-man, 59-man rumble.
Oh! Right in his Captain Planet balls.
Think about it like this. It's like the greatest Royal Rumble, except we have women.
Well, Default's... is China really... And Captain Planet!
We got dead women.
Oh, and Default's eliminated.
China proving that she has a bigger dick than anybody in this match.
Well, she probably does. China just low-blowed Cancer.
Hit Cancer right in his dick.
Cancer has a penis, apparently. But, I mean, what did Cancer shrivel it?
Oh my god.
China picked up Cancer!
China is trying to kill Cancer right now, people.
Oh, hold on.
If anyone can do it, it will be China.
I think Christopher Notwinski trying to get rid of Harvey Weinstein. God. Oh, God. God's like, you weren't allowed to leave, too.
Hold on. God.
Oh, Jesus.
The gutbuster.
Harvey Weinstein is somehow not eliminated. How would you feel, guys? Harvey Weinstein wins tonight's belt.
I am a big fan of his.
Not surprised,
Sonic. Not surprised? What's us pushing?
A lot.
Look, contrary to popular belief, I listen to consent.
Yeah.
I do. Jared Extreme here has said on multiple occasions I do not. However, it is a family matter.
Here comes the man! The myth, the legend, Carl Winslow.
Other SMF legend, TV champion.
He is a Carl legend, yes he is.
Carl Winslow. John, what do you think of Carl Winslow?
God!
Christopher Notwinski eliminated God, and another low blow.
Oh, that's not going to feel good.
Here comes the cane. Will he eliminate the father too? John. Just like he eliminated the son.
I'm sorry? What?
You think of Carl?
Oh, oh there goes Harvey.
Well, I think he's taking the smart... never mind.
Here comes Shane Skate. Beforehand!
What?
I hate everything. What the heck is that?
That's Shane Skate back in Nakamorehand! And he's about to get rid of cancer! Nope.
Suddenly, I do not know how to speak English. Because all I speak is that money, 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 money talks.
God bless America. This is what you get into when it's the crazy stuff people's division. You don't know who, what, or whatever is going to show up.
Shut the fuck up, bitch!
Well, and here comes the Shane chokeslam and Shane's getting McNakamura hand.
You got it.
How did I say that in one attempt?
Yeah, both right. Another low blow by China. She just giving out low blows. She's taking Shinsuke's gimmick.
Yeah, well, I mean she was gimmick doing it long before.
Well, I don't know if it was low blows. It was more like blow something else, if you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. No, she did do low blows as well. Hey,
but yeah, she was getting blowed. She has a penis. Can we all just stop denying?
Carl Winslow about to be the man that could defeat cancer.
Now, if Nicole Bass showed up, we'd have a dick off.
And here comes Reptar.
Oh.
You know, the Rugrats reboot just got announced recently, so Reptar's got to be very excited. He could come home with a bit more gold.
Oh.
And that is,
That's Reptar.
I guess you could say that. Why does Reptar have a bunny tail is what I'm wondering.
No! Here comes the gate!
Look, we couldn't afford the whole tail.
Here comes the Kane eliminated when Mason Chronic comes back from his hot pocket break. He's gonna be very upset.
Yeah, but he might be happy because Reptar's here, guys!
Cancer and Reptar, I mean, this is a battle that we only thought you'd be able to see in your head, but well, now you're seeing it in real life.
One Kane leaves, and another one joins us. It's Pimp Kane.
That is, I'm spoofed.
Don't let you keep your women at home. Let the hose out. It's Pimp Kane.
I'm very
hold the hose. Here comes the demon.
I apologize for disappearing like that.
Chronic, while you were gone, here come the Kane got eliminated, and Reptar got in, and Reptar's gone.
Reptar! My child.
But also, Chronic, Pimp Kane's here.
So we lost one Kane and got another.
Yeah, but we got Pimp Kane and Shinsuke McNakamorehan in trouble by cancer.
Did God eliminate Here Comes the Kane?
He did.
God has avenged his son. This is biblical times, ladies and gentlemen.
My favorite Bible verse. And China about to eliminate God.
He's about to be like...
My favorite Bible verse is Corinthians 3:16. China has a dick.
Oh no!
I like
oh no!
Corinthians.
Wow. Oh my God!
China and Carl Winslow.
Oh my God! China deadlifted cancer. So,
fun fact, China's father thought she was a lesbian.
Fun fact: we get to see cancer's tag partner.
Speaking of lesbians,
another full blow to cancer. And here comes Osama bin Laden.
Isn't this another SMF legend?
Obama bin Laden for a second, and I thought I was going to laugh a lot harder.
Another SMF legend. He's back.
This looks like the chef of my local
family. China's on the ceiling, don't fuck.
And it's not her time of the month. Because she doesn't have a penis. I mean, a vagina. She has a penis.
It's very nice that all these SMF legends came out as we're going to have Bob Ross on commentary for festivities.
We'll see Bob Ross.
Bob Ross is part of this.
He will be commentating with the Doc legendary tag commentary team right now.
Yes.
And here comes Mr. Sprinkle. You guys are in for a treat.
Didn't I tell the Doc to retire?
Mr. Sprinkle? What?
Oh my.
There goes Carl Winslow.
I want one.
I think I know who's going to
stop cancer.
If anyone
can end cancer, it's Mr. Sprinkle.
Riley film. The fuck is this?
Osama is out. So well,
I'm scared.
I heard...
I'm literally scared.
Scared? Why are you
this
scared?
Is beautiful.
Oh! Here comes legendary Japanese wrestler, Mr. Coke!
Mr. Coke.
I was actually trained with this man.
You were trained by Mr. Coke.
Mr. Coke.
Did Coke indeed about to eliminate China. China's probably had a couple dabblings of Mr. Coke in her lifetime.
I did wrestle for NJCW. Mr. Coke is the head trainer at New Japan Coalition.
That is true. He is the head trainer.
Runs the dojo.
Mr. Coke having his famous battle with Senor Pepsi at Kingdom Wrestle.
Well, I'd like to point out that while you were saying that, Shinsuke Nakamura-han got eliminated.
Cancer's still here. He just won't go away.
You won't go away. No matter how hard you try, it just stays with you.
Drop kick by Mr. Sprinkle.
I think Mr. Sprinkle has got a shot here.
Now, guys, I think Mr. Coke was number 21, maybe? We still got 9 more entries before we're crowning our first, our third ever champion. Teddy Roosevelt, Alex Jones, who's joining the list?
Could be anyone.
Mr. Sprinkle.
It could be Mr. Sprinkle.
It's Mickey Mouse?
It's New Dawn Pro's very own Mickey Mouse.
He's the king of the world.
He is? Oh.
Oh, Mr. Sprinkle.
Mickey, looking swagged up.
Uh-oh.
I mean,
uh-oh.
Cancer's in trouble.
The man's about to make another fucking shit ton of money after the Fox acquisition.
Oh, Cancer.
Cancer's in trouble. Nope, Cancer just, again, Cancer won't leave. Cancer's here forever. Will Cancer be able to get in time with his tag partner, though? Oh. And it's
gotta be Raven.
Guys, it's Crazy Stuff Division's first ever Hall of Famer, Maven. And holy shit!
What? Oh my god! Oh no! Maven, no! I've seen this before.
Maven just eliminated Cancer.
Oh fuck! I've seen this before. Maven's in trouble.
Cancer's
Maven. Maven, look out!
Cancer's gonna find the popcorn machine, and Maven's screwed.
I would like to make one thing very clear. In the 3 appearances, now this is his 4th time Maven has been in these matches, we haven't seen a dropkick yet. Oh my god!
Jesus!
And it's the Party Man!
COH's own Party Man.
He did a dropkick. Hold on. Maven did
a dropkick. You guys do know, I actually trained this dumb British fuck.
You trained the Party Man.
Guys, Maven did a dropkick.
I know, it was...
He finally did it. It didn't connect because Mr. Sprinkle is incredible. But
mentioning his pal Cancer in this matchup.
I am in shock and awe over what we just saw.
I mean, like I said, first ever CAW All Stars, Crazy Stuff Division, People's Hall of Famer Maven eliminated Cancer like fucking butter.
We already have a Hall of Fame. Oh my god!
Mickey! Go into town on
Mr. Trump announced via his own personal Twitter, we have a Hall of Fame now. Maven is the first entry along with another man who we will see later on in this match. Making his return from the first ever Battle Royal back at that weird Knox thing.
Can I be in the Hall of Fame?
Guys!
King Booker!
Tell me, I did not just see that.
China just doing the impossible and low-blowing Mr. Sprinkle.
China is winning off of low blows right now. I don't know if you've noticed.
Did you guys know this about King Booker? He's a former 35-time wrestling champion.
My ass. Wait.
Check his Twitter. Check his Twitter.
15. Eliminated by the Party Man.
And Mickey Mouse just hit like a weird reverse STO on Mr. Coke.
Look, I don't know about you, but in Japan, we call that the Blade Runner.
Uh-oh.
I need to make something. I don't know what the hell I was about to say. Curb stomp to China.
Please, no, don't do it. King Booker, don't do it. Please, God, no. Don't, no, please, no. Thank God.
They got Maven! Maven's in trouble?
Oh no!
Maven's out! You better watch out for Cancer because I hear Cancer's
pissed. Sorry, I didn't know if anybody noticed, but King Booker did a spinneroony. Call us a spinneroony. By the way, so there you go. The first of 2 Hall of Famers eliminated, and I think China is about to get rid of the party man.
We got the Battle of the Behemoths.
Holy shit.
Poor party man. But Mr. Coke?
My trainee eliminated only from my trainer himself to get this dumb bitch.
Mr. Coke about to get revenge and eliminate China? Now, I'd like to say, the only, like, two entries we knew going into tonight, we know V-Pac is in this. He hasn't shown up yet. We know Donald Trump's in it because he puts himself in all of these things. Besides that, we don't know anybody. They haven't shown up yet. Donald Trump, this is the latest he's come in.
What were his last two numbers?
He came in at like number 7 once. And here comes Big Baby.
But I thought you said Donald 28? Trump was coming in later.
Wait a minute. Here comes Luke Andrews. Oh wait, never mind.
Nope, it's Big Baby.
Luke Andrews isn't in this match. He's too busy being in a hot tub.
Look, I just have to say, my top two favorites right now, Mr. Coke, and I hate to say it, but China. China has been dominant.
Or Mickey being eliminated by whatever that thing is.
It's demographic.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
I jinxed it. I jinxed it.
And here comes Andre the Ape. Oh my god, Big Baby just on a roll right now.
And
it's Andre the Ape.
Oh, what did you guys do to Andre's body?
Oh, again, this one was a little bit harder, but we got a guy, we can't tell you how, to dig up his grave and get a little bit of DNA. And there goes your trainer.
Look, I just have to say, I feel sorry for Booker T. Look at who he's in the ring with right now. Look at the size difference.
Your trainer just got eliminated.
Fuck him.
And here comes Security.
It's Moon Moon.
Guys, it's Moon Moon. He will round out the first half of this.
Why is Mr. Sprinkle doing that with his shoes?
Here's Moon Moon.
I swear, every time I see Moon Moon, he puts on a little bit more winter weight.
That's what happens when you're in a tribe, you know? You hibernate. You're like a bear. That's what the Indians do, you know? I mean, that's what we did to them. We made them hibernate, but, like, permanent.
Hold on, you insensitive fuck. They are Native Americans.
Oh, yeah, the other ones are dotheads.
Whoa! Oh.
What?
Guarantee no comment gets said about that, too.
Probably. They're like, who cares?
You're worth
it. We don't want to agree with you.
Alright, guys, so we got Andre the Ape, we got Moon Moon, we got Mr. Sprinkle, we got King, Booker, and we got Big Baby. Who wins?
Look, yeah, I don't know who wins this one, but I know who John Blackos is supporting.
King Booker?
No. Oh. The legend of his country, Andre the Ape.
Well, Andre the Ape is technically created in a lab somewhere in Jersey, so he's technically American.
But it's part Andre.
No, move on!
I don't know, Booker has a good shot, but Mr. Sprinkle...
Guys, one of these four men, quote-unquote, are going to become the third ever CAW All Stars crazy
Mr. Something. Sprinkle with the AA!
The F-Leads is Big Baby. Who's everybody got?
I'm going with Big Baby.
I'm going my boy, Mr. Sprinkle.
I'm going to King Booker.
Fuck that. Fuck John Blackos. I'll go with Andre the Eight.
So we each got someone. Here we go. Mr. Sprinkle. Now, guys, we have a whole second half. Now, one of these men will now join 29 other men. Right after this, I mean, as soon as the winner gets his belt, the next entry, he's coming out. Who knows?
I'm confused. Is this just like a joke that I'm not getting, or is this just someone's like strange creation?
Well, no. So let me explain. Back at All Stars 8 and/or 7, we can't remember. Some stupid idiot called the Knox, and fuck, goddamn it.
What was he?
No, I'm referring to Mr. Sprinkle, not the division.
Oh, well, let me explain my story.
The division's a joke.
So.
It's a scary ass baby. I'm just gonna say that right now.
Baby, he's 38 years old.
Oh, that's my child.
So what? So some stupid idiot named the Knox did some open challenge, and backstage politics, I'll call it out, didn't want to give us the belt from some stupid Fed that was apparently going to come back, but it didn't. So there we go. So instead, I went to Mr. Walsh, decided to come up with this division. But then we needed money to do another one, and Donald Trump became president. And he's now funding all of this, and that's why we have 60 men instead of fucking 30 now. And it's pretty much open gate. Whoever shows up, and that's Mr. Sprinkle.
Oh! Mr. Sprinkle caught Big Baby with a spear. Mr.
Sorry, guy. Shooting there. Hi, Colt.
Big Baby looks like if Suzuki had a son he was disappointed in.
$5. They don't say a damn thing.
If Suzuki was disappointed in his son, he'd probably pile drive. Let's be fair. Speaking of Suzuki,
he'd put him in the sleeper and go for the couch.
I hate that man.
Uh-oh.
This is a battle of the behemoths. Is this the new King Kong movie?
This is preview of Godzilla, God of Monsters.
Godzilla, that's right. I'm fucking stupid.
So what we have right now is Mr. Sprinkle, obviously, is Godzilla. Andre the Ape here, obviously King Kong. Big Baby, obviously, Luke Andrews.
Did blood just fly out of the nose of Mr. Sprinkle?
He's got a nosebleed.
Now, I'd like to make it very clear that I don't think Mr. Sprinkle is human.
I mean, it doesn't have a species. It's Mr. Sprinkle.
I'm being told he comes from the planet.
Is Johnny Thunder?
Big Baby looks like the alien baby from whatever that movie was. It was like came out in like 2007 or something like that. It's like the baby turned green.
Thunder the Mask?
Is that it?
I don't know.
Yeah, I remember the trailers. That's what it looks like.
Well, Big Baby is a Chinese wrestling legend, Sean. So don't be disrespectful.
Oh, because we would not want to be disrespectful. We haven't done that tonight.
Well, he's a legend sumo wrestler in China.
Hold on. Walsh, you want to talk about respect?
What do you mean?
Do you not remember? You're the reason I went to Japan.
Look. That was an old me, you know, different times.
What, like last week?
I'm a good guy now.
Mr. Sprinkle about to put the FU to the Big Baby.
I'm just gonna say this couch is weak.
Wait, is he gonna... Oh my god.
Going for two?
Oh my god! Who picked Big Baby again?
That would be me.
You're in trouble right now. Mr. Sprinkle is dominating, I must say. I kind of want Mr. Sprinkle to win.
I want Mr. Sprinkle to win first.
Well, Mr. Sprinkle is a free agent, right? Again, he's an ape, and he's also Andre, so, he's going to be slow. Come on now. Big Baby?
I wonder how much alcohol do you think Andre the Ape consumed before coming out here tonight?
Well, he's also an ape.
You're saying an ape can't enjoy a nice drink every now and then? You fucking racist.
Racist towards what? Apes?
What the fuck? Ow.
He just did a leg drop at a bulldog. Big Baby, again, like I said, sumo wrestling world champion. 38 times at the age of 38 in China. He won one every year.
Oh. I don't recall Andre ever doing a snap DDT, but I'll take it.
Well, he's a fucking ape, and Andre. I think you think he's the real Andre the Giant. Jared, he's dead. He's been...
For half the people in this match.
What?
It wasn't Osama bin Laden. Isn't good.
Well, that's what you're supposed to believe.
We have a time machine.
Can it bring Kofi Kingston back to 2009?
Was created in the
best, best year.
The Brahma Bull and Andre the Ape were created in the same year.
Is that where we made all the Canes too?
No. The Canes are a family. That's racist. That's mean.
They were not in his family.
Every single one of those Canes comes and gets you.
Wouldn't be the worst thing that's ever happened to me.
How many Canes are there?
Well, there was two in the first, and I think there was like four in the second, and like five in the. There's at least almost 20 Canes. So just imagine how many of those Canes are gonna kick your ass, Dad.
I mean, let's look at this. Remember, Kane, the original Kane, is a product of adultery. So I mean, it's entirely possible that all these Canes were produced.
Well, why were they not in the campaign party?
Well, Dean, would you really want all of those Canes to be with you? I mean,
I most definitely would.
I don't know if Pimp Kane is the most politically correct person to be in your photo. I mean, he's got Rainbow Kane, and he is the gay one, so. He's Rainbow Kane! That's his whole deal! They each have a gimmick! He's gay!
Oh, jeez.
No, it's fine. He's cool with it.
He's cool with it.
By Donald Trump.
Well, Donald Trump isn't here. He's going to be in the second half. So, I mean, we have a whole... We still have these three fucking behemoths going at it. Mr. Sprinkle's in trouble. Oh, my God, no. Oh, no. Jared.
No. My pride and joy might be eliminated.
My baby.
Pride and joy.
I mean, look at him. He's adorable.
Yes!
Andre the Ape, just, you know,
this has gone on for way too long, I'm just gonna say it right now.
Like, this someone is a throw wrestling classic, what do you mean?
Better trying to win a belt, Jared. I'd like to see you get in there and fight.
I'm gonna go win a belt, go to a fucking belt store.
Yeah, Jared ain't gonna get in there.
So. Jared's a bitch!
And oh my God, you know what? That's what you get, Jared, that's what you get.
I just wanted the words Mr. Sprinkle to be on, like, the CAW All Stars website. Is all I wanted. And then show a picture of whatever that is.
Well, that's why he's a bitch, and that's why that happened.
Well, sadly, one of these men will get the grace the page of CAW All Stars website. Sean, I hope you're proud of that.
It is what it is.
You created this.
Look, this is more Trump than me.
Well, I mean, this is his 50% ownership.
Well, you know, someone wanted to make CAW fun again.
Well,
so
definitely done that, I must say so. I mean,
Donald Trump is the reason Matt Black defected to DZW?
That's an awful accusation. Why would you say something like that? Donald Trump actually a big Matt Black supporter.
How is he?
Yes. He bought his t-shirt, wears it to work every casual Friday.
You know, I fuck his daughter with him sometimes.
Wait, you fuck Matt Black?
Put Andre to sleep.
Chronic, that looks familiar.
MK47! Oh, lesbian.
I think, big, oh, shit.
Okay, you dumb bitch! Hold on, there's a dumb lesbian going at me. I'll be right back.
We've all been there.
I mean, I guess so. I mean.
Now, Big Baby now trying to get Andre out, but Andre fighting him.
Andre the Ape, Big Baby, they want to win the belt. One of these men is being the third champion. We got 29 men in the back. They're waiting to come out.
The L's in the LGBT community, not fans of Mason Chronic. So I had to go beat an ass in the audience.
You beat up a lesbian, is what you're telling the live audience.
Exactly what I'm telling the live audience.
I mean, as long as you're alright with it. And oh my God, Big Baby!
Yes! Big Baby's done it.
Big Baby is the champion, guys! Big Baby, the third ever CAW All Stars Crazy Stuff People's champion.
He's more than a
Do you understand what this means? Now he gets to go backstage now. He gets to see. He gets to heal up a bit, I guess. I don't know. I'm still stoned. It's the pre-show. It's fun. We're here in LA. It's legal. And I'm allowed to do it backstage. So, you know, that's good. I was told so by Trump.
If this was in Amsterdam, you'd just be able to do it all the time.
But anyway, guys, Davey is the third ever CAW All Stars Crazy Stuff People's Division's champion. He now has to immediately defend that fucking title against 29 other men. And guys, here comes entry number 31, and it's Satan.
Oh, wow.
I've been told Satan multiple times, and I guess I'm just now meeting him in person.
Well, guys, it is true. I mean, for multitudes of years, we've been told Satan, and he's finally reared his head. We've seen Jesus. We've seen God. It was bound to happen. We've seen Satan.
We've seen all the caves.
Well, not all of them yet. Glenn Jacobs is yet to come out, and I think there's a few other caves that have yet to show up, but a lot of big names out in the first round, so can't wait to find out what we got going on in the second round.
Wouldn't you say this man is in close relationship with the caves?
No, he's Satan.
The
caves are hell's favorite demons.
So I assume, alright, so then they just work for Satan.
Look, it's a close family friend.
Well, he probably got a ticket somehow here. I mean, Satan, I must also say, I am pretty damn terrified.
It's pretty spooky, terrified,
but that's Satan, guys.
Me and Trump play poker with this man.
Can we just make it clear that Satan's here?
He's here. Look, there's the depths of hell.
I'm just wondering how you booked him, is what I'm wondering.
I don't...
Didn't you just hear he's a close friend to Trump?
I don't think...
Okay, that makes all the sense in the world.
I don't think Jared understands it. Did you not hear what I said earlier? These matches are open-door policy. There is no booking. There is you show.
The lover of Saddam Hussein is in the ring right now.
And... Oh, is Big Baby not starting the match?
And guys...
Oh, it's a veteran!
I said it before, Maven was the first, and I said we had a second, and he's making his return, second Hall of Famer, it's Pokemon Brock.
I love it.
He's back. Pokemon Brock making his return, he's back, and he's gonna start off with Satan. Oh, Big Baby gets to go back, he draws a new number.
First of all, let me just say, Pokemon is available on Crunchyroll.
Oh, so that's
a good one. And,
Crunchyroll sponsored Chronic.
And so, some would say, I look like this man.
I mean, I hear he's your papa.
I wouldn't be surprised if he fucked my mother.
Wait, so is this the man who entered the room when you were doing a CCWL promo?
This is my dad.
Interesting.
So we've seen your trainer, the man you've trained, your child, and your dad. And there's the belt again. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful belt. Of course, sponsored by Big Show, KFC, Snickers, and Butt Out. And
why the Big Show?
Give me a holy shit, why he's not? Tall.
Oh my god.
Shit, he's tall. Oh my god, Brock. Pokemon Brock.
You act like you've never met Satan before.
I haven't met Satan before.
I've played poker with him all the time.
Where would I have met Satan, Walsh? I met you. You tried to ruin my company.
Oh, no.
Yeah, and you tried to ruin my career.
Alright, I get it. Ha ha ha. Used to be a bad guy. You guys gotta get over it. I'm a nice guy now.
I mean, you did send me to Japan.
Anyway, here comes another legend, Christmas Benoit. He's here.
He is here.
Christian Payne in the ring.
Benoit. Good friends with Satan.
I'm surprised these guys are going at it here. You would think they would be teaming up.
Well, he's Christmas Benoit.
Still.
Well, do you really think Satan likes Christmas?
Yes.
That is true.
Isn't Satan Jewish?
Here comes Carl Weezer.
He is gonna want to buy the York croissant.
Pretty gay, bro.
Oh!
Whoa. Carl Weezer.
He needs to be careful. He might need his inhaler.
No llamas tonight, but if Carl wins, I mean, he'll definitely make enough money to buy one.
See, no llamas? Is that confirming there is not a llama entrant into this match?
No,
still comes Stone Cold ET.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh no. Oh no.
Oh no.
YouTube legend.
I never thought I'd see this man again.
And at one time, competed in NJCW.
Give me a home, yeah.
He's in trouble right now, though, by Christmas Benoit. Satan. Christmas Benoit.
Satan beating the shit out of Brock.
Here comes Samoa Joe Raleigh.
Here we go. Oh, that's not what I thought it was going to be at all.
That is most definitely not what I expected.
Mr. Ross,
he's hyped.
What do you think of Samoa?
Joe is hyped.
He's hyped and he's ready to go.
Wearing his Zumbas.
Yes.
See, I was expecting another man.
Oh no!
Here comes Sho Funaki.
Oh no!
No.
It's Sho Funaki, baby.
Well, it's Sho Funaki.
Wait, hold on.
I think we just got an elimination over there.
Oh, it's Carl Weezer eliminated. I think he had an asthma attack.
Aw, what a bitch.
Oh, that's a nice job.
Jared, you're so mean. You don't got the tenacity that these men have to get.
Oh, and here comes Shinsuke!
Uh-oh.
Member of the Kane family.
Didn't we already see Shinsuke?
No, that was Shinsuke McNakamorehan. This is Shinsuke. As Samoa Joe Raleigh is in trouble by Pokemon Brock, Sho Funaki's going after Satan, and Stone Cold DT in trouble by Shinsuke.
And oh!
Well, back to the drive-thru he goes.
I missed that man.
He's still here, Jared. He's right there. He's gonna come up. You can say hi.
Christmas Benoit. Calling for something big. And a beautiful drop kick.
Fucking show.
What? What, Chronic?
Brock and Sho were in the corner. Maybe looking to break the ring.
That was a whole different Brock and Sho. That's Sho Funaki, that's Pokemon Brock. That's not Brock Lesnar and Big Sho. What are you talking about?
Steve, you're the only one to imply that.
That's their names. Do they look like Brock Lesnar and Big Sho to you?
Yeah.
Jared, don't encourage them.
So you're telling me that doesn't gotta be Kane?
No.
But here comes Bo Leave.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Is it him? Is it him? Is it? It is! It's Bo Dallas! The current tag team champion.
Member of the B team.
And my heart.
Remember, B team stands for the best team.
It could also stand for Bazy Stuff People's Division Champion.
I'm sorry, what?
Oh no, Satan, stay away from my baby.
No, Big Baby hasn't entered yet.
No, fuck off, Sean. My pride and joy is in this match, and he's getting beat up by Satan.
Oh no, no, here's your pride and joy.
Oh my god.
Here comes Connor the Crusher. Here's the
human. Thank god he wasn't in the last match.
Oh, Shinsuke! Oh, the human ashtray is here.
I hope Triple H isn't in this match, or else he might be a little scared.
Connor the Crusher eliminated Satan.
Thank god he wasn't in the last match.
For real.
Connor the Crusher eliminated Satan. Connor the Crusher was able to evade cancer, though, but he is still a human ashtray.
I don't know what your vendetta is with this kid.
He's just a boy.
He did something wrong, and we don't need to talk about it.
Okay, I get it. He called some bimbo crazy.
What did you say, Jared?
I said he called a woman, a beautiful, lovely woman, crazy.
You know what, Jared? I gotta make a phone call.
AJ Lee's a slut.
I'll be right back.
Well, guys, it happened again.
Classic.
Look at
classic cowardness.
Brock doing moves I've never seen him do before.
That was a different F5.
Okay, I'm back. Jared.
Hold on, wait.
Important announcement. Jared, you're welcome.
Okay.
That was TMF5. That was not just the F5 that we seen.
Jared, you're welcome.
Alright, boys. What's up next?
I don't know.
Oh!
It's Pikachu! He's also a veteran to this shit I've never seen before. See, you know?
Pikachu made his return in the first crazy fuck duck, whatever the hell it's called, when he was presumed dead for many years. But he's back.
See, I have a question. The last time we saw him, he had a lot bigger ears.
Thank goodness.
So,
why did Pikachu's ears shrink, is what I'm wondering.
Well, again, like we said, I mean, you know, things did happen.
But so they were bigger last time I saw him. Wait, but he was
Brock
in the last match.
Ball at him. It's gotta be! It's gotta be Cash!
But his metal arm, for some fucking reason.
Bucky Barnes, guys.
Yeah, apparently that's what he thinks he is. He's back again. He doesn't look like a trash bag.
Why is he so tiny?
I don't know, because he's a fucking Mexican.
What does that mean?
Hold on.
I don't know.
I don't remember him being this small.
I don't either. Connor the Crusher is like almost the same height.
Connor the Crusher is pissed. He's like, you are. Connor the Crusher is like, no.
Somebody get rid of this pipsqueak. And I don't mean the human ashtray.
Can I get rid of him too?
No,
Connor the Crusher is. I think he's angry at Cash for appropriating his culture.
I will say this: we have tried to get Connor the Crusher for a few years. There was a reason we couldn't get in touch, but we got him this year.
Is it because he's
just like that? He's gone.
Thanks a lot. Is it? Jared.
Is it because he's a damn?
Well, I mean, yeah, we were able to revive him somehow. And Christmas Ben was out, and he lasted a pretty long time.
Oh, guys, here we go.
Yeah, you're welcome. Get the fuck out there. Get down there. Take your headset with you.
I wasn't serious when I said this earlier. Why? Oh.
Come on. Let's see how he does. Guys, let's listen to see how Jared does. Show Funaki's going.
I did think he was wearing awfully short clothing out here.
Show Funaki eliminated. By
guys,
the way,
I hit the headset in here, so I think I'm doing pretty good.
No.
You can see my mustache. It's a beautiful mustache. Alright, I got this.
Pokemon Brock still in here since number 1. Pikachu!
Oh, shit. Oh, boy. Ow.
Pikachu eliminated. Jared, go after Cash. Don't catch his cancer, though.
I got my own strategy.
Oh.
Your strategy
is going out for Brock. Mojo Rally is about to go.
You know, jelly-filled donuts are my favorite. Oh, fuck.
Jared,
strategy was to go after Brock. You are a dumb.
Well, guys, I think this might be it.
Oh, Jared, I think it's time.
Come on
back, buddy. That's what you get for saying what you said before.
You're so fucking awful.
Guys, I noticed that there was four people in the ring, but only three toothbrushes.
Well, we know Brock uses a toothbrush every day.
Holy shit!
I don't know about that one.
Guys, making his official wrestling debut. It's
the turnbuckle!
Did you not see it run past you?
Not like we said. Henry, the turnpost. ECF.
ECF rules.
He left ECF, detached himself from the ring, joined CrossFit, he's here. Guys, this is the first ever turnpost you're ever talking, ring post you're ever commentating for.
What does this shirt say?
It says, I'm fucking Henry.
Of course it does.
And
Godzilla 01!
I don't remember a Godzilla movie coming out in 2001.
Well, no one knew what years were until 2001.
And Pokemon Brock is gone.
Speaking of people not knowing, you know, it's no, a good point you bring
no,
that up.
No. Don't mush the minds of these people.
Everybody, Chronic brought up something, and I'm not going to go into details, but he did bring up a point. You didn't know what year it was until 2001, and you do now, and you know why.
Thanks to a man who was in this,
and there goes the movie. Well, that was easy, that was quick.
It's gotta be!
Guys, he's here.
I'm gonna make a bold statement here. The mayor of Knox County
just did a meteor up. My pick to win. Guys, I don't know if you know this, but I mean, my baby Bo is gone, but my pick to win right now is Henry, all the way.
Yeah, I'd like to say Henry.
Now, I've been told Henry officially signed when you need ECF contract.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he's going to be our official turnbuckle going forward.
I don't know why was he not contracted beforehand?
We didn't have a turnbuckles union until
No, he's a ring post, dumbass.
Two politicians coming out.
He's a ring post. He's not a turnbuckle. The turnbuckle are the things that are the little things on the side. He's a ring post.
Do
you not know what a ring is? He's a ring. He's Henry. He's fucking Henry, and he's beating up the president.
I mean, the owner of CAW All Stars having a little bit of a difficulty 50, right
50,
now.
50% owner.
Oh, hold on. No,
the
no,
real
no,
owner
not,
of CAW All Stars.
No.
Oh,
of Justice
Stephon Frogman.
Justice Division.
Guys, it's the debut of Stephon and Ribbit Bitch. He's here.
Tell me how the fuck this happened.
Easy. Well, again, that's the actual Stephon Guerrero. We just bleached him green.
Why is he a frog?
To explain, if you've ever seen what Stephon Guerrero looks like, he looks like a fucking frog person. He looks like an amphibian. So we dyed him green, gave him a shirt that said "Ribbit Bitch," and he's here now. And here comes Bill Cosby.
Sean, do you think we're gonna get any comments for that
this
one?
This is another man that I love.
Even if we did, nobody would respond.
I wonder, is Little Bill going to be in this match?
No, but Bill Cosby has a chance.
That was a good show.
Hey, look, if Bill Cosby gets his way, he just has to drug all of these guys.
Do you think Stephon Frogman has an issue with Bullet Club t-shirts?
Probably. We gotta wear LIJ shirts. Woken, Matt!
Making his return!
He's gotta stay woke! Stay woke, ladies and gentlemen!
Oh no! No! Yes! Henry! Woken Matt just standing there. Woken Matt's in trouble. Woken Matt! Oh my god! Oh my god, Woken Matt! He's eliminated! Holy shit! Oh, Woken Matt!
Man, that almost won,
Oh, and there goes the Mexican. Dirty spit. Anyway.
Whoa, okay. Whoa. The views of Adam Jackpot do not coincide with the views of CAW All Stars.
The views of a lot of what we have seen thus far do not reflect the views of CAW All Stars. Remember, I only get 50% say here. Someone in this room.
You all.
Hey, why are you talking about Samoa Joe Raleigh like that?
You all think the same thing about him. Come on.
I wouldn't use that word. Donald Trump and Bill Cosby, to some people, could be considered a dream match. Happening right now. Donald Trump versus Bill Cosby, and how many sexual assaults can you commit in a 5-minute period, man?
Jared, you said the first funny joke of the night. A dream match.
That's not what I was,
Wow, Jared.
Referring to.
Jared, that's very insensitive.
Stefan Guerrero with a Samoan driver.
That's not Stefan Guerrero. That's Stefan Frog.
Sorry.
You just said that was the actual Stefan Guerrero.
Shit. It's the best bowler in the world. It's Will Wild.
Or Wild Will.
You see, Will Wild put a Wild KO, ladies and gentlemen.
Stefan Frogman in trouble.
Will Wild once main evented a Shock Mania for SNW.
I hear.
Didn't he also once main event a slam for the tag belts?
I think.
Will Wild, despite what you say, he's a very, very accomplished.
Donald Trump is gone.
Oh, look,
he's once main event of the 2016 election. But here comes Vince
SNW.
Here comes Adam Jackpot's mom.
I don't know how that makes sense, Jared. He's a man.
Bro, let me tell you.
Wait, Stefan Frogman.
Before there's blacks there, bro.
Stefan Frogman eliminated by Bill Cosby. Who got rid of the Don?
I don't think
we're actually doing what we were called here to do.
I mean, we kind of. I mean, how would you with this match?
I mean, I've been drinking this entire time, eating my hot coffee.
So, Big Baby yet to come out. He drew a great number, obviously, to retain his belt. And V-Pac still yet to make his entrance.
That's right.
The only other guy we know about being in this match.
Starting to think V-Pac might see who was in this
Glenn
match.
Glenn Jacobs, the only current politician in this match.
That's true.
That shirt does say, "I'm fucking Henry."
Who's fucking Henry?
Henry, the turnbuckle. It's the ring.
Oh, you yell at me for saying he's a turnbuckle.
You fucking kept saying it, goddammit, Jared. You know, if I wasn't backstage, I'd come back there and kick your ass.
How do you feel about your mom being in this match?
This would not be the first mother of someone to enter a Rumble in CAW All Stars. The first CAW All Stars, Steven Syntax's mother entered that match.
I wouldn't be surprised if my mom entered this match.
Comes vacant.
We've seen my dad. We've seen my trainees. We've seen my trainer. If my mother comes out next, I would not be surprised.
You have vacant another DCF legend. And oh! No, fuck you, Vince Russo!
This is Russo booking, bros.
This is the worst day of my life. Henry, this is the worst day of my life. Yeah,
Hold on. I can't help but
I want to point out that Samoa Joe Raleigh has been in this match for like 20 minutes.
Bacon and Henry look very similar.
Well, I mean, technically speaking, Big Baby's still in this match, so.
Make some noise!
The V-Packinator.
So many eliminated. Okay, so
Glenn Jacobs,
and so is Vince Russo. And to make it clear to you, Jared, Big Baby has never been eliminated yet, so he's in this match the longest so far.
So he's pulling a Stone Cold in 99?
He's pulling more like a D-Bry.
Oh!
But anyway, V-Pack here, so everybody else besides Big Baby.
Wait, hold on, Bill Cosby?
With the sleeping pill.
I was gonna say the implant buster, but that also works.
Oh, 72 court cases.
That must be some sort of record.
Here comes William Cosby.
Oh,
taking on
whatever the V stands for, Pac.
I don't know. We gotta make some noise.
What? Virtual wrestling.
Oh!
Oh, what the? What? Well, I mean, obviously, if you didn't know, Vacant gains the moveset of every wrestler he had to vacate the belt from.
That actually makes a lot of sense.
He's about to choke slam. Here comes the Underbaker. And there goes
Rawling.
And here's the Underbaker.
And that's not what I was expecting, but
I hear he's worked closely with Chef Johnny Thunder.
Now, Sean, what do you think of Underbaker?
Is he on Instagram?
Yes, he shares a special souffle every Wednesday.
Guys, we're about to get another entrant. I just realized Will Wilde's wearing face paint.
Will?
I think it might be free.
It's... Oh, I thought you said this was dead.
Well, we had
to...
So originally, Hollywood Harambe was supposed to be here, and he would have been the last Harambe to send it off, but he broke late. So we got one last person, a new Harambe made specifically for tonight, Ultimate Harambe.
Are you sure?
This
Hollywood Harambe wasn't shot in the Hollywood Zoo.
Just like the Canes, the Harambes will tonight also be retired.
That would have been a dream match. The Canes versus the Harambes.
Here comes the Undertaker.
Oh no. I was hoping it was going to be a cow dressed as the Undertaker.
But
this works too.
Half Undertaker. And there goes Will Wilde by V-Pac.
What is this, COH?
Now, next year's CAW All Stars pre-show, we will see 8-man tag Canes versus Harambe. One year's time.
First
announced for CAW All Stars 11.
And oh my God, it's Brian Zane. So Big Baby just gonna come out here in like one of the last two spots.
He drew a great spot.
I did just realize we are at 28.
Yeah, we have one left person that we don't know, and Big Baby.
Brian Zane.
We're getting to the end here. We were going to say something, Jack. Oh, and there goes Bill
just
Cosby.
Just eliminated Bill Cosby.
Just like Bill Cosby.
Bill Cosby, he was in here quite a long time.
Bill Cosby eliminated a lot of things to women.
Oh, Ultimate Harambe!
Oh, Underbaker! On default, Vacant was here earlier.
Just kind of dropping Vacant.
Oh, here comes...
Guys, I must say, this has been fantastic.
I've had to yell at lesbians. Oh, been a good night. Rather be at the Crunchyroll press conference.
What a great main event this has been. Sadly.
And Brian Zane going to the top rope, well, the middle rope.
Oh, great.
No, he's not. And here comes the Big Baby.
Yes.
The Big Baby. Number 29.
Here comes the champ.
You gotta wonder, is Big Baby gonna be the first ever Crazy Stuff champion to successfully retain their championship?
That's true, or will we?
The champ is here!
We don't know what number 30 is, but like I was trying to say, we have some great tag team, junior opener to start off the pre-show.
I have a question.
Great nights of calls.
Are former champions allowed to reappear?
I mean, we've seen a lot tonight.
So could we see Teddy Roosevelt at number 30 try to regain his belt?
We'll find out.
Probably not. But Brian Zane's in trouble.
Big Baby about to give Brian Zane a big-ass choke slam. He gone. And here comes Andy Kaufman.
Oh, my God.
Guys, he's not dead.
Somebody called Jerry Lawler.
Andy Kaufman's here, and he's the last man in. Oh, my God, what a shock.
Wait.
Whoa.
He did it again! So, guys, this is it. Who's going? Oh, well,
Big Baby. Oh, I thought that was it.
So, guys, Big Baby, Ultimate Harambe, The Undertaker, V-Pac. I think I might have said him already. And Andy Kaufman. Who's going to win the belt, or is Big Baby going to retain?
I think Big Baby retains.
I'm not saying I've lost faith in Harambe, but they all retired after tonight. So if he retires and he wins, is he retiring with the belt?
No, if he wins the belt, he won't retire.
I'm going to go with Cow Taker.
I mean, it's the Undertaker.
I'm going to go with the Humongous Baby.
We got two for Big Baby, one for the Undertaker. I'm going to go for V-Pac. The guy's had a great showing in essentially his...
V-Pac weighing in the shots.
If V-Pac's had pretty much a successful, I mean, essentially, what would you say, beginning rookie year, made it to the finals of the Young Lions Cup, has been very successful in COH and DCA.
I got to say, that I think Big Baby's gonna win this, but I would love to see V-Pac win. I would love to see that.
What is a V-Pac?
The guy in the blue shirt.
Who? I think I've seen him before.
Well, he might be saying goodbye, courtesy of Andy Kaufman.
Oh, no.
Yes, he is.
No. That looked like a nasty landing.
The childhood dream.
Guys, I just want to point out, I haven't been able to get this stupid headgear off. It's like stuck to my headset.
Well, you know what? Shut up, Jared. That's what you get. But you know what? V-Pac, his dream was to get to Call All Stars, and he made it.
Yeah, he finally made it here tonight, and something tells me this won't be the last time we see him here.
The next step for V-Pac is get on the main show next year. Tonight he was on the pre-show.
That was a passive-aggressive comment if I've ever heard one.
You know how hard it is to get on Call All Stars.
Oh, there goes Andy Kopp.
Backhanded is what I
aggressive
meant.
Comment.
Backhanded is what
that
I meant.
That wasn't either. That was the hopeful for him.
Oh Jared my God! To spin the Undertaker. It is very hard to get on Call All Stars. It took me so much.
Oh my God, guys! We might be seeing
the end of the Harambe era.
Is over, and so is the Canes. But guys, we might be seeing history here tonight if Big Baby wins.
Hold on. Undertaker.
Oh,
he just milked him.
He milked the baby.
Look at that camera angle.
He's an ass man.
A lot of this makes sense, technically. I mean, Big Baby, he's an Undertaker. That baby wants to suck on them udders.
Them titties.
Dad.
Oh, I was right!
No!
Guys, no. The fourth ever Call All Stars crazy stuff. People's division champion is the Undertaker.
I'm just saying, I called it.
I'd like to make it so. Teddy Roosevelt, Alex Jones, Big Baby, and now the Undertaker. What a phenomenal.
Look how excited he is.
What a match.
Give me that.
He's gonna, oh man, oh, I'm waiting for the milk bash.
Was this the Undertaker's first appearance?
This is over, that's what this is.
Undefeated.
We'll see you guys on the main card.
Quicksilver is the winner!
No.
And he nails it!
Has won Cross
Titles. What the fuck?
Kevin Cash is back!
Evan Rocksville making his return to Call Wrestling here tonight.
And a condom device and Shawn Ross is tapping.
Come up the stage.
If you put him on
the stage.
Oh yeah! No!
Yes!
This night, Ray Geddes got the best of Ben Hitman.
No, he's signaling for the end here. No, not Redemption Road!
AJ Young has cashed in, and now he's Call All Stars champion.
Anarchist versus Unarchist.
These three men are attacking the Call All Stars champion.
AJ's gonna steal it to become the first ever two-time Call All Stars champion.
Just one simple mistake that gave Sean O'Connor the victory.
Cody wins! Cody wins!
Cody just beat Casey Corden!
Cody's won the tournament!
What is going on here? Are we having our first ever Call All Stars dance-off?
Oh man, it's time for my top 10 metal albums of the Rumble.
Care. Care.
Oh no.
Wait, what? It's actually him or Order!
It's now the first ever Call All Stars Women's Champion! Bowser's down!
He's done it! He's the new Dawn Pro Champion!
The Disciples have just won the Call All Stars Tag Team titles!
Amazing Chronic regain. It's the
He's got him!
Brandon Wolf is the Call All Stars World Heavyweight Champion!
Hey now, you're an All Star, get your game on, go play! Hey now, you're a rock star, get the show on, get paid!